Hi, I'm Dr. Anthony Edwards, and I'm the instructor for social media use and education. And today we're going to be talking about social media safety and social media policies. So let's start with social media and safety. So educators have a responsibility to think about how they're going to help promote use of social media, but not just use, but safe use of social media. And as you probably know, there are many objections to using social media in education. And those are similar to many of the objections people have to using educational technology in general. There is a humorous video in Canvas that kind of talks about this. The point being that we, you know, as educators sometimes put up a lot of barriers as to not wanting to try new things. But we usually use those for things that we're not comfortable with, whereas for other things, you know, we are able to sort of get past those barriers. And so, you know, sometimes we have to look at, are we being truly objective in comparing social media to other forms of technology? All right, let's talk about safe and secure social media use, and specifically in the context of social media policies. So there's a social media policy assignment that you all are going to do in reviewing a social media policy. But here's some things to think about. So social media policies should do these things. So they should obviously provide recommendations for using social media safely with employees and students in the district. These policies should also promote ways to use social media that align with the curriculum is being taught in a particular subject area. That you're not really using social media just because it's cool or just because it can both be a tool for engagement, but it can also be a tool to teach the specific content area. And social media policies need to be able to incorporate social media in ways that make sense for the grade level and subject area of the students. So the ways that you would incorporate social media in a first grade classroom should be different from the ways that you would incorporate social media in an 11th grade classroom or in college. The ways that you incorporate it maybe in science would be maybe different than the ways you incorporate it in English. So it needs to be you know, consistent with what you're teaching. These social media policies should allow for parent consent. Parents do have a right to have just some choice and some say in how social media is used when their students are involved or when their kids are involved. That can range from releases in terms of pictures, you know, video, if their kids are in the pictures or video, and whether they get grant permission or not, to even more substantial in terms of understanding the ways in which social media might be used to teach the students in the classroom, even if their confidentiality isn't compromised. So it's always good to make sure parents and stakeholders are included and involved and are aware of what's happening in the classroom. So social media policies should also provide alternatives. So, you know, there might be certain social networks that your district blocks, and it's there's a non-starter conversation as to whether or not you can use certain ones. Are there other social media tools that you could use? And figuring out what makes sense for your curriculum and what you want to do, and are there other ways that you can use social media if platform A or B, social networking site, you know, C or D is not allowed. Another framework to think about in terms of using social media in education is the teach, perform, regulate. So you should be teaching students how to use social media effectively and ethically and responsibly. You should be teaching your colleagues how to do that. You should be, in terms of performing, you're using social media to engage students and to teach students, show them, help them understand the content. Then you should also be regulating, you know, and making sure that it's being used safely, all right? And making sure this is being used in the ways that you intend for it to be used and at the times you intend for them to be using it. You may not want to give students free range to use social media in your class anytime they want to. You may need to be at specific times and certain activities, but you may not want to just say, hey, you can be on your phone the whole class, because students may not really be paying attention. All right. But helping them understand what they need to do and doing it effectively and correctly. In terms of roles and responsibilities, we're going to focus on the school board administrators first. So the school board and the administrators have a duty to the internal stakeholders, that's the students and the staff, to make sure that as the governing body of the school district, that students and staff are being taken care of and are safe. And so making sure that whatever social media policy is in place, that it protects the safety of students and also supports learning. They also have a responsibility to external stakeholders, you know, like the community and parents, right? We talked about parents already. You know, the community should have a right to know that social media could be used and how it would be used and why it would be used, okay? It shouldn't be a surprise to parents or the community. Considerations that school board and administrators needed to think about with things like the culture of the school and the district. Is there a culture of promoting excellence? Is there a culture of using technology and innovation? All those things social media could be weaved into. Device accessibility. Do students have their own devices? Do they need to be provided devices in the classroom? What about when they're at home? Are they able to look at videos and things that you post on social media? So all those things need to be taken into account. Like if you flip your classroom, can students watch the videos at home? Could they do any assignments at home? Those are all things you need to think about. School law, so if there's obviously any legal issues, you know, you have to make sure those are addressed. Privacy issues, obviously, again, you know, showing students without, you know, permission, you know, there's some privacy, FERPA, you know, issues that, you know, you need to address. And just ethical use, making sure that students, faculty, and staff know what is appropriate level communication, what types of things are appropriate when using the Wi-Fi, things of that nature. So for teachers need to be able to model and teach what ethical social media use looks like. So that way the students know what to do because they see it. All right. They've also got to be able to communicate and provide the input of what the administrators and the school board need to include in the social media policy because you may be more familiar with it. So what are the expectations of the district and the community regarding social media? What things need to be excluded? You know, are there certain types of social networks that need to be excluded? What kind of safety precautions are in place? So in terms of parents, making sure that you know teachers provide support for parents so they can help teach the students about ethical social media use and support them at home, because many students have social media accounts. In many cases, the parents are aware they have them. But the parents may not know how to help their students use them ethically and effectively. Okay, and parents, again, while I don't put this on responsibilities because we can't really put responsibilities on parents as educators, things that we can help them with, again, is teaching and modeling ethical social media use so that they can use it well and also help their children to use it well. Also providing input, parents can provide input on the social media policy, you know, in terms of things that they feel comfortable with, things they don't. So it's important for parents to be involved. Okay, in terms of social media and its relationship with learning, it's a concept here called the four C's. So, and these are going to be integrated with social media. So critical thinking, you know, use social media in ways asking, you know, higher order thinking skill questions. Are they creating images, video, blogs, you know, written long form content, short form content. Communicating, you know, how are they communicating? Is it audio, is it video, text, images, collaborating? Are there opportunities for students to interact with each other, to work in groups, or just to communicate with, you know, and express their ideas to one another? So all these are different ways to learn, and they can be done on using social media in one way or another. Okay, and again, social media is broad, so you know, social media is not just Facebook or just TikTok. You know, there's again all these different kinds of social networking sites, that some of which your district may allow. All right, so the assignments for the week: you have a discussion board post in Canvas on the effects of social media. You've got a class project in a Google document where you read a social media policy and you write your response to it in the Google Doc, and then you comment on someone else's reaction. In your Canvas group, you're going to do the review of research, and I really want to encourage you this week to try to use either Google Scholar or the library databases. I created a video that's in that first module. If you have any questions on how to do that, I really want you to start looking for actual research and how that relates to the course. And the LinkedIn post, you've got that for the week, and then the verification form that just documents that you've done these other four assignments. So I look forward to interacting with you this week in these assignments. If you have any questions, send me a message in the Canvas inbox. And if you enjoy this video, please hit the like button, subscribe, and share, and we'll see you in the next video. Thanks. Bye.